Okay, now we look at question 3. The question 3, if you read precisely the question, we can write down the information that we have. You can see the initial velocity of the sprinter at t equal to 0 is equal to 0. V naught is equal to 0. This is t naught equal to 0. And the position here we call x naught equal to 0. It means we put our the origin of our coordinate system at this point. Here we have v1, which is the maximum. You see, the sprinter reaches his maximum speed in 2.5 seconds. Here it's V1, which is equal to the maximum velocity. The time is T1, which is 2.5 seconds. Well, you can, and X1, which we don't know, and it doesn't matter what's the value. Again, here is the final place. You have V2 at time T2 equals to 10.40 seconds, and you have X2. Your x2, here is the origin of coordinate system, your x2 is equal to 100 meter. What about v2? If you see, the question says when the sprinter reaches his maximum speed from the rest, it means this is 0. After that point, he maintains the speed, yes? Till he finishes the 100 meters. Maintain the speed, it means constant velocity. It means after point T1 till the final point, we have a constant velocity because he maintains the speed. Then this one is equal to V1, which is V max as well. Now we want to draw the curve of velocity versus time. This is V as a function of time, and we have here time. Again, there is no unique approach to solve this question. But as one of the possible solution, we look at the graphical approach. Okay, at time equal to 0, the magnitude of the velocity is 0. Then we have a 1 point here. And also the question says that T1, which is equal to 2.5 seconds, we have the maximum value of the velocity. We call it V max. But between this point and this point, what's the behavior of the velocity function? It's linear, it's quadratic, it's cubic. If you see here, the question says from the rest with constant acceleration. What does it mean? We know acceleration is nothing more than dv over dt. It means the acceleration is the gradient of the velocity curve. And when the acceleration is constant value, it means your gradient is constant. Gradient constant or slope constant means a linear behavior. Then here we have a line, and as question says, between T1 and T2, 10.4 s, he maintains that speed. We have a constant velocity, which is a constant line. This is what we have for the curve of velocity versus time. But the question asks, what's the value of the maximum velocity? Again, we can start from the basic definition. We know the velocity is nothing more than the first derivative of distance versus time. From this one, if we take the integration with dt, t naught, for t naught is 0 to t final, which is t2, equals to dx x naught to x2. X naught is equal to 0 as well. X equals to 100 meters. If we simplify, this integral is nothing more than 100 minus 0 equals 2. Now we have this integration for the velocity between t naught, which is 0, and t2. For me, it's easier to divide this integration in two parts. This is the first part, and this is the second part, because then easily I can calculate these two areas, because I know the area under velocity time curve is nothing more than the distance. Then I can divide this integration in two parts, integration from t naught to t1, this part, with dt plus t1 to t2, and t1 is equal to 2.5, t2 is equal to 10.40 with dt. Okay. For the first part, from t0 0 to t1, which is 2.5 seconds, this integral, yes, I just rewrite it. For the second one, is from 2.5, 10.40, again the v. This is nothing more than the area under the velocity time curve between 0 and 2.5. The area of this triangle. And the area of this triangle is 1 over 2 V max multiplied by 2.5. And again, we can see this integration is nothing more than the area under the velocity time curve between 2.5 and 10.40, which is the area of this rectangle and is equal to V max multiplied by 10.40 minus 2.5. Now if I just rewrite this one, I will have 100 equals to 1 over 2 V max multiplied by 2.5 plus V max multiplied by 10.40 minus 2.5. Equals to, okay, we have one equation, one unknown, which is V max. From this one we can easily calculate V max, which is approximately equals to 10.9, and don't forget to put the units. Okay, this is solution of question number 3.